lack of integrity on the part of many of our leaders. The Red Card campaign was a way of demanding for a people-driven constitution, and that was the main pillar. I championed the Red Card campaign with many other Zambians. It was a success because the general public embraced it. I supported PF because I believed that among many other things, they were going to fulfill the delivery of a people-driven constitution in the manner captured in their manifesto, which all Zambians agree should be the ideal to proceed. When PF came into power, after a year or so, I was given a job at ZESCO. Many people know that. When I realized that these people were liars, I decided to disengage. And I've continued. I have continued to advocate a people-driven constitution. When you look at those people in government today, the president included, this has not been the path. This has not been the example they have shown us. Now, coming back to the issue of the constitution, the problem that we have in this country is that we fail to understand, many of us fail to understand, that the reason for experience is bad leadership. Bad leadership thrives in an environment where laws are bad, laws are weak. And the supreme law of our land is the constitution. We are agreeable that it's a defective constitution, it's a bad constitution, it is that
way,
it presents
just to just get a little bit bubbly. You have never been in PF as a one part. You've never been a politician until recently. Now, did you believe when you are pushing for that transition from PF going into power, did you believe in their promise?
I've never sought for office before, but I want to believe that I've always been a politician. And I think that when I was born...
You say you've always been a Christian. Okay, you can go ahead.
Yes, and I think when I was born, the cry that was heard in the hospital was a political cry. So I've always been a politician. Did I believe that PF was going to deliver a people-driven constitution? Yes, I did. Do I believe that they are going to do that now? I don't believe, because there is no political will. That they have clearly demonstrated. And one of the reasons, perhaps the main reason why PF would not do it, is that they are typical politicians who engage in politics as an occupation. And politics, you need to stay in power. And you can only perpetuate your stay in power if the laws that give the people power to decide otherwise are weak. And in this case, our constitution makes it easy for politicians to manipulate and scheme and stay in power.
As an opposition leader, there is something that opposition political leaders can do to resolve this problem.
There are a lot of things we can do. But I want to believe, without sounding pessimistic, I want to believe that the success of this process requires a lot of political will for those who are in government. For a simple reason, that refusal to deliver a people-driven constitution on the part of PF is more a moral issue than a legal issue. And therefore, we have been trying to put pressure on them to honor their word, to deliver a people-driven constitution. Now, I wanted to make one important point, that maybe it is time the organizers of this forum and other concerned citizens and stakeholders to begin to chart a different way forward altogether.
What do you think would be a different approach? Support is for dialogue. You are renowned for demonstrations. Where do you meet with civil society organizations for you to advocate for this constitution?
Thank you. By the way, demonstrations are part of dialogue. Yes. Because when you demonstrate... demonstrate, it means to express yourself. So it's part of our dialogue. However, It is in human nature that when you are expressing yourself and somebody is not listening, you want to hold them, maybe by the jacket, you want to hold them one or another, to draw their attention to something important to what you are
saying. And before he gets to, should get into, should get into the audience as well. Don't worry, and then we can allow our friends to join us live. Many of these individuals that we allow to comment are representing civil society organizations that have been ignored or well known to talk every time there's a constitution making process. Of course, we'd like to recognize the presence of former Vice President. Okay, we also have Kalaki. You seem to have run out of cartoons to describe the processes. And obviously, this particular program would not end without getting your opinion on the constitution making process.
My friends, people of people, my friends, we've talked a lot about the impasse and even political will. I don't know who this man political will is. He seems to stand in the way of everything. But it seems to me, if you want a cartoon, that we don't seem to know the difference between constitution and constipation. With this impasse, we have constipation. It is a constitutional form of constipation. We can't get anywhere. And if we're talking about what is our method, is it dialogue? Is it protest in the street? What is it we're dealing with? What is this impasse and why have we got it? And let me explain it simply. A constitution is a set of rules which the people give to the government. And the people say, by this set of rules, you are allowed to govern us. And if you don't govern us by these rules, you are out. And the Zambian people have never set such a set of rules because we are stuck with what the colonial government gave us. Now we are trying to give our government a set of rules. We're trying, I think, for the third time now. And when we give the set of rules to the government, who was supposed to say to us, yes, thank you, you've given us a set of rules, we should now rule by these. And the answer always is that we are the government, we don't like the set of rules which you have given us. And we are going to write a set of rules for you by which we would prefer to rule you. That is the basis of the impasse. And it is not an impasse which on the face of it looks like it's open to dialogue. It looks like a very firm sort of constipation. Because this constipation is so firm and so solid and so immovable that it has been with us for 20 years. We give our ideas, we give our demands of what the constitution must be. We have a constant input to the process, but we have never got any output. We always have constipation.
As we allow the panelists to as well give us their take on a number of issues that have been raised. Vincent Chen happens to be the president for Radical Progressive Party, and I think most of us have heard about that party. Former last president there, Radical Progressive Party president, actually joining us in the audience as well. We also have a new elected vice president for Zasu. In the name of Martin Lundwe there, and I think I saw the Public Information Secretary somewhere. Do we have the president here? Okay. We should get into the audience and the rules of the game. I'm going to line up.